Hello friends, welcome to our part 2 discussion on this particular course image processing on RAMP, where we have already completed 61% in our previous video. If you have not checked my previous video, please go through the link given in the description box. I'll be posting the link of my previous video there. Already I have discussed major steps like importing an image, do some pre-processing like converting the RGB image to grayscale, then adjusting the histogram and improve the contrast. Okay, then we have done intensity based segmentation, that is nothing but thresholding, and for that we have used adaptive thresholding using IM binarize, right? Then in my previous video I have started the post-processing, that is after segmentation and before classification some processing we need to do, like one kind of post-processing we have done, that is removing noise from image so that thresholding will be done properly. Now this time is background removal, isolating the image background. Okay, received image that have a busy background are more difficult to classify because artifacts basically distorts our raw sum. Okay, pollute our raw sum. Okay, so like here you can easily understand that in the backside broccoli kind of things are present. Like here I guess this is kind of some bell pepper kind of things, and which might distort our raw sum, which is one of the most important feature to just classify whether a particular image is received or not. To mitigate this issue, you can isolate the background and then remove it by subtraction. Okay, so what we have to do basically, in this particular post-processing stage we are going to extract this particular background, and then we will subtract the background from this original image, and as a result only this texture part, text part will be getting, where we'll be applying our raw sum feature extraction. Now try to understand, if we want to extract only background, that is from this image, if we want to get this, what we have to do? See, very simple. Here this particular, if you just observe, let me just make this bigger. Yep, see, these are text, so these text are black color. I have to merge those. Okay, so simply we can use IM close function, and this will be closing all those with the white or bright pixels, right? And it will be generating this. Now once we get this, we can subtract this one from this one, and as a result all the backgrounds will go away, only this texture part will be remaining. Let's hope that we'll be getting that. Let's go to the next, and here one video which explains the whole story you can explore. I am directly going to next, and by this time we have already completed 64%. Let's hope that by this end of this particular video we'll be completing our job. So here what it is saying, in the received image, the background is anything that is not text. By using structuring element larger than typical letter which is used as text in our received, each window captures what behind the text and not the text itself. Okay, that is, we'll be taking sufficient large structuring element, we'll be applying our close function on that, right? So as a result, all the text will be closed and only the background part we can extract. Now we can subtract the background part from our original image, and we'll be getting basically our only textured part apart from the background. Okay, right, create a disk structuring element and store that in AC. So I will be writing STREL of our disk structuring element. As you know, this is kind of circular shape structuring element, right? And this then radius is 8. Just I'll be submitting this. If you want, you can give semicolon. This is important not to show the result here. Okay, if you don't want to execute this, so you can give semicolon, no problem. Let's go to the next part. Okay, let's apply IM close function. Okay, now here apply IM close function to GS using the structuring element. What is GS? GS is basically our grayscale image. Okay, and what is our original image? Our original image is this kind of shape. All right, so GS equal to IM close our image. So here actually we have to store in IBG, right? And we have to apply on GS and here AC. We have to display also. And let's run this. So if you check our original image, that is this kind of having this kind of hand shape. So if you just extract the background part, that is if you apply IM close, all the text part which is basically applying as darker part due to application of IM close function, all this will be filled with the white part and we'll be getting this kind of thing. Okay, as you can see that it is kind of appearing like we have removed the text. That is, this is nothing but extracting only background. Now we can subtract the background from this original image and the rest image will be containing only the text part. Okay, that's what it is asked. Go to the next task. So basically we have to do subtraction. Subtract GS from IBG. What is GS? GS is our original grayscale image and we have to subtract from IBG. Okay, IBG is this one and store the result in GS sub. So GS sub equal to IBG minus of GS. Right, and let's run. So see what output we are getting. See, only the receipt is coming. As you can see here, this was our original image. We have extracted only the background part. Now this is completely white. Now white minus black. Okay, so what will be happening? And basically it will result to only the extracted part. That is, where in this particular image white color is present, but in this particular part black color is present, that time only that will appear as white and it will reflect. Like here in the rest of the part where there is same intensity present, like here the thumb is present, here also thumb is present, both will be subtracted and will result to zero. So as a result black will be coming, right? So this is nothing but applying kind of bottom hat transformation which I have already discussed, right? First apply closing and then subtraction to extract the background part. Anyway, right, and let's go to the next task. Inverting the binary image, that is nothing but we have to apply this particular symbol. All right, so here we will be inverting because you can see that it might increase the readability of this particular image because completely black, right? So we can just invert this. So here BW use IM binaries on GS sub without any option and not operation and store that in BW sub. All right, so BW sub equal to complement of IM binaries of GS sub and display it. Run this. Sorry, IM binaries. Let's submit this. Yep, all correct. See, only text part is extracted. So from here, actually where background was present, we are able to remove that. And the algorithm is quite simple. First close that. As a result, what will be happening? When you will be applying image closing on this, all the text will go away. All part will become white. Now from that, you just subtract this image. Okay, as a result, you will be getting only the this particular text part which was closed while applying IM closing. Okay, and then you just invert this and you'll be getting this one. And in future task you can explore, like I have told you, this is bottom hat transformation which can be computed using IM both hat also, bot hat, BOT HAT, BOT for bottom, HAT for bottom hat transformation, right? Let's go to the next session. Okay, so like this we are learning the post processing. Okay, right, now enhancing the text pattern. So text pattern, what is that? We have seen that oscillation kind of thing should happen, that wherever text is present, that particular, for that particular row sum will be small because in the text part zero values are present, so row sum will be lesser, and where text is not present, that will be completely white, higher values, so row sum will be more, right? So how we can enhance this text pattern? That is by just combining all the characters. Okay, that is, we'll be connecting all the characters, right, which algorithm we have followed for counting number of lines present in a text, right? So let us check. Like here you can see, this is when we are applying image opening, what is happening? See, this is our actual text, and if you see, due to application of image opening, this text are basically merged. Actually, when you want to merge something, that means you should apply closing. But here you just see the pattern. you should apply closing if the foreground is white, black background is black, what generally should happen. But here reverse thing is present, that is background is white, foreground objects are black, and you want to merge, so you have to apply reverse thing what we generally do. So generally we apply closing, so this time we have to apply image opening, right? Okay, so I am closing this. Now here some piece of code is given which I have already discussed: reading one image, converting from RGB to gray, then adjusting the intensity, passing fire, moving average filter so that noise can be removed. Okay, then finally we are applying background removal or background suppression algorithm, and then we are complementing of the thresholded value, right? And eventually what we are getting, we are getting this one. Okay, this is our original RGB image from where we have started, and eventually we are getting this one, right? And now to improve the text pattern, what we'll be doing, we'll be just joining all this text. Okay, so for joining all this text, we have to take one horizontal line structuring element or rectangular structuring element they are telling to take. Okay, we'll be taking that and we'll be applying image opening, because generally for merging we should apply image closing, but here foreground objects are black, background objects are white, so reverse of general thing we have to apply. Generally we apply closing, so now we'll be applying opening, right? Simple. So AC equal to task is use structuring element to create rectangular structuring element with height 3, width 25 pixel. Obviously height will be lesser than width, because small height we have to go in the vertical direction, but large width we have to take so that all can be merged, right? Simple. So REC, so structuring element, so STREL stands for structuring element. Okay, right, and here I will be passing rectangle. Okay, and here I'll be passing 3, 25. I have shown example with line structuring element. This time we are using rectangular structuring element. Alright, so here AC we have written. Let's run this. Let's check whether our code is correct or not. Yeah, correct. Let's go to next task. Apply opening. And store in BW strips. And display it also. Close this, submit this. So see what is actually eventually happening, that all the text are merged and now it is becoming like this. Now if you apply row sum algorithm, obviously what is going to happen, that where text is present, actually their row sum will be very less. Okay, actually this is we are doing instead of directly applying row sum on our binary image, segmented image, we have to do like this, because you can understand here also if you apply row sum, then it will also not be 400 like that, it will also become less due to this kind of background pattern. But if we apply this kind of thing in the post-processing, where we are basically merging all the characters, individual characters present in the text, so row sum will be decreasing very much, by a huge amount, right? And that will help us in proper classification. So let's go to the next task. Sum the rows BW strip. Okay, right, so sum of row strip comma 2 and plot, store the sum in S variable, plot. So see, it is looking like this. Now what we have to understand from this, that actually everywhere, see, it is going down and going up like that. Okay, so from this particular one, pattern finding is difficult, but as we have applied this kind of merging, what is happening, where actually text is present, it is going very much down. Okay, so from this we can just separate or distinguish in between the text part, where in which rows text is present and in which rows the it is going down due to this kind of background. Okay, because you can understand where it is going very much deeper, there actually text is present, right? Okay, now go to next task. Compute the row sum of the original signal BW and store the result in SBW. Use hold on and plot in the same window. So we forgot to give hold off. Submit once more. So see, you can understand this blue one is after marching like this, and this red color type one is for this one. So as you can see, red color is not going that much deeper, but blue color text pattern is going very much deep side because of this kind of marching in the row wise. When you are taking row wise sum, most of the parts in a particular row are becoming zero, and as a result it is decreasing by huge amount, right? Let's go to next task, and this is future practice. If you want, you can explore. Let's go to next session. We have completed chapter 4. Congratulations, 70% completed. So now what we have to do, see here the code which we have already written, that is, this is original receipt which we have applied different pre-processing, segmentation, post-processing, and eventually we are getting like this after background removal, okay, and enhancement in the row sum calculation, all these things, right? And here what it is asking, select image 3 from the drop down. First select image 3. Let's submit this. So image 3 look like this. As you can see here, perfect way we are getting like this. Now we'll be going to next task. What it is saying, adding interactive task to live script. You can add an interactive task to live script by selecting the live editor tab in the MATLAB toolbox and then navigate to the desired task. All right, we'll be doing if we require. Okay, let's go to task 2. Add a find local extrema task to code section, provide for task 2 and 3, set the input data to S and set extrema type to minima, leave the other setting as it is. So we'll be going to task, and here find local extrema, we'll be clicking, and here it will be loading. Okay, so here actually, as you have seen that in our plot, we have to, okay, let me just show you that here, is this present? Nope. All right, no problem. So we were here. So as you can see here, that when we have plotted the row sum, then there where actually text is present in a particular row, for that total sum just went down. Okay, so those are minima. Now those minima we have to find out. Now the minima was might appear for some other reason also, due to some noise present in the background also it might appear. So we need to adjust those properly. So add the final local extrema to the task code section provided in the task 2 and 3, set input image to S. So I'll be setting to S, and set extrema type to minima. Extrema type is maxima, so I'll be putting there to minima. Leave this other setting as it is and submit. Let's check, correct. So what is happening, if you observe, just try to understand and interpret. See here, actually this is our 400 which is completely white, but no text is present. As soon as text is coming, the row sum is going down. Now this down peaks we are computing using local minima finding algorithm directly from the live editor. Okay, let's go to the next task. Set the prominence window value to 25. Okay, right here we'll be setting to 25. Then increase the min prominence value until there are exactly 9 minima found. So these are settings which you have to do using trial and error method. Okay, so min prominence value, where present? Here. So now it is 31. Many we are getting. Let me change. I am just randomly changing. Let me make to 50. It is coming to 14, decreased. So I'll be increasing to maybe 60 from 14. Let us check whether it is decreased or not. 11, right? Let me make this 70 and run. 9. All right, so perfect. So in 9 we are getting at mean prominence 70. So see here only justifiable minimas are detected. Okay, let me take the see carefully, only which are actually minima in their own regions, those are detected. Okay, so now let's submit this and it's correct. So let's go to next task. Change the drop down task to image 6. Here we have to change to image 6. Do not alter any setting. I will not alter any setting. I will be simply submitting this and all correct. So see here also image 6 also, this is our image 6 where after applying different pre-processing, segmentation, post-processing, we are getting this, and when we are applying our minima algorithm, we are getting this. Perfectly, the major minimas are detected only. Like this one is not that much justifiable minima. This might appear due to our background. So this one and this one detected, this one not like that. It is justifiable, right? So let's go to the next task. Change the dropdown to image 8. Do not alter anything to interactive task. So now see, this is not at all an image of script. And as a result, we are not getting that much local minima also. Previously, at least we were getting local minima 9, but here we are getting only 4, right? So using this particular code, if we are able to calculate number of minima, that can be used for classification, like at least 9. Okay, because we have set it the property such that it will detect at least 9. So let's go to next. Apply the classification method to an image. So the process image is nothing but the function. If you just check open process image, if you go see helper function, no need to worry about that. Something new here it is done, same thing what we have done earlier, converting to grayscale, adjusting the intensity, passing mean filter to remove noise, then removing background, then here rectangular window we have used to increase the enhancement in the row sum. Okay, and then we are computing the sum, right? And then here we have set the properties. Go to task 1. So what it is saying, count the number of minima mean indices using the NNZ. Okay, NNZ is the function which will return non-zero numbers, and that we have to store in nmin equal to count the number of minima in mean indices. So mean So what actually we are doing here, try to understand. Here mean indices we are computing. First we are doing all the kind of processing what we have done. Then we are passing via this kind of setup to compute the number of local extrema, which is local minima in this particular case. And how many local extrema it is finding, we are computing here using NNZ. That is non-zero number. Because this mean indices, what it will return? It will return basically 0 or 1. Okay, right. So mean indices is 0. That means that particular extrema is not considered as local minima, and mean indices is 1. That means it is considering that as local minima. The array mean indices generated by find local extrema task is logical array indicating the locations of the minima. Where minima is found, that will be 1. Otherwise, it will be 0. As simple as that. Okay, right. So this is the code generated by this task only. And here we'll be writing this one, and let's run this. Okay, all right, all correct. Then create a logical variable is received, that is 1, if nmin is 9 or more. So basically, whether received or not, how we are going to find? We are going to count number of minimum indices detected by our task. If that is at least 9, then that is received, because that kind of oscillatory pattern is present in row sum that we can conclude. So is received equal to, what is that? Simple nmin greater than equal to 9. Is received will be 1. If minimum 9 local minima is present, ill that will be else that will not be a receipt, right? So we'll go to next task. Here we can go to next session. Now image data store regarding that video is present, you can explore. I have already discussed about image data store in my machine learning video discussion, so I am directly jumping to the next session, which is 80% completed. Okay, right. Now image data store is nothing but database of images where images are present, which you need to classify or train like that. Create an image data store DS. Okay, right. DS is my image data store named DS for a folder test images. You may leave off the semicolon to display the output. Right. So image data store of test images. Okay. Right. And here we can leave the semicolon. Whether you are keeping semicolon not, that is not that much matter. Okay, so see here this kind of output we are getting for image data store. Right, so access the files properties of DS. Here you can see this is kind of key value pair, so files is files colon some value. So if you want to access the values, you just simply use ds.files like that, right? So store the result in data files name. So data file names equal to ds.files. Submit this. Correct. Then count number of files in the data files using numel. So number of elements. So num for number of elements. For elements it is el. Like this you should try to decode and remember each functions, or you can simply Google, no problem. Okay, numel of my these data file names. Submit. Correct. Okay, because here nothing new related to image processing concept or machine learning part is there, so I just these are just recap session kind of thing. Now read image function, load nth image. As you know, read the first image from the database which we have created, data store, and that is stored in I and then display I, right? So read image of my database, and one we are passing first image we need to check, and I am show I. Run this, and this comes our first image, no problem. Let's go to next task. Call the function classify image function. Now you might think, where we have done classify image? No need to worry, this classify image function just only you have created here. See, converting from RGB to gray, adjusting the intensity, passing via low pass filter, which is our moving average filter to remove noise, then applying our bottom head transformation to remove background, then applying image opening to enhance the row sum of property, then we are computing row wise sum and counting number of minima, considering mean prominence as 70 and prominence window as 25 as mentioned in the question. Okay, and we'll be classifying this as received if minimum number of elements is at least greater than equal to 9, right? So just we need to call this. Okay, is received equal to classify image of I. Run this. Oh, sorry. Yep. And now try loading another image. Okay, if you want you can do. I am going to next section. Now this we have done for one image. Now we have to compute for all the possible images, right? So here we are going to use one for loop. Add a for loop around the code in the task so that it loops through all the files in DS, number of the files in DS stored in n files. Don't forget to change all these things, you can explore. Okay, so what we have to do, simply we have to classify each image whether there is received or not using one for loop. So for I equal to 1 colon, okay, what is that? N files, which is storing total number of files present in my this database, and we'll be ending this. Okay, right, and here I'll be just copying these two lines also and pasting here. Instead of ds comma 1, here ds comma I, that is ith image will be taking, and classify of our image, and this will be stored in is receipt of I. Okay, and is receipt will generate one array, and let's submit this. Correct. Then here ds.files is received. That is display only those files which are received, right? So let's, so ds is our data store, and then files, using that we are accessing the files, and is received is received. Okay, submit this. Sorry, here actually we have to create this variable. Received files, that's contents. Yeah, correct. And you can display all the files present in the received files using montage. Let's show that. Here only let me write montage of our received files. Submit. So let's see how good way classification is done. Let me put here. Okay. Why it is not displaying montage of received files? Here it is showing this kind of way. Yep. So see, these images are basically classified as received files. This is received, yes. This is received, yes. This is received, yes. This one, this one, this one, this one, this one, this one, and this one. All these are received, correct. This only is misclassified. This one, natural view, is also classified as received, but anyway, no problem. And this is black spot is indicating that here no more images to show. Now let's check those one which are not received. Okay, I am closing this. And here, if we go to next task, so using not operation, you can check those which are not received. I'll be simply pasting here, and I'll be just doing complement of is received. Let's run, evaluate selection. So see, these images are not received. Okay, this one, see, none of these are actually received, and this is black indicating here no more image to show. So with this we have completed our journey. Okay, perfect classification related to only images, no machine learning concept we have applied, and this is our helping function which we have created by our own by performing certain tasks step by step. Okay, right, and let's go to next section, and we have you have reached end of module 5. Let's go to next chapter. Okay, congratulations, you are on the way to going real practical image processing in MATLAB, because you have seen this is completely real-time use case. If you want, you can explore this image processing resources. Steve on image processing in MATLAB is a very useful resource. Okay, the blog quality, content quality is really nice. Okay, if you want, you can take this particular 14-hour course. Okay, this is paid one. Okay, right. In-depth coverage of image processing is present, right? Let us go to next, and you can explore all this. Let's go to next. Okay, how did you learn about this course, MathWorks website? Okay, how do you rate the level of difficulty? I am giving like this, you can give according to your choice. Content within the course, I should give 10 out of 10. Software use delivery 10 out of 10, because the complex classification problem they have divided into different stages, such that the job is actually very easy. Okay, based on my learning experience, I experienced a lot. I am giving 9. If you want, you can add some suggestion and submit this. Congratulations, you have completed the course. Okay, and you can go to your own learning path. And here with this we have completed our journey on image processing on RAMP. See, 100% completed, and you can access your certificate also. right? So I hope you have enjoyed this particular classification problem. Very interesting and completely real time. Okay, just the main feature extractant, that is row sum, will be having certain kind of oscillation in any receipt, right? So I hope you have enjoyed this. Code I'll be posting in the description box or in the comment section. If you want, you can go through that. But don't forget to check my previous video where I have discussed the part 1. Thank you.